Right, I'm here on the Somerset Lanes with Dave Hemming from Freeflow. Can't even say it now. Right, I'm out here on the Somerset Lanes with Dave Hemming from Freeflow Technologies and riding another new e-bike motor.
Yeah.
What a lucky guy I am. Not that new, because it's been, 11 years in development?
11 years in development. The last 4 years have been a real catalyst for pushing the technology over the line into production.
Yeah.
Which is where we're now at. We're selling out to a number of brands now. We've got 30 brands be launching later in 23 into 2024 with our product, which is really exciting.
So just to be clear, this is a production motor. This is something that you can buy now, effectively.
Buy now, ready to go. Brands are buying them to develop their frames. Real sweet spot for us right now is the handmade bike market. They really can't get into that space. So we offer the motor brackets in steel and alloy so those brands can get in on this.
Okay, so normally if you were buying into a motor system, well, firstly, there's the issue that you've got to buy a certain number of motors.
Yes.
Which for some of the major brands is,
it's pretty high.
Into the thousands.
Yeah, it's pretty high. So for a handmade side of things, they're making one-off bikes. They need to be able to access something almost instantaneously.
Yeah.
And deliver that within, you know, a couple of months or a little longer, depending on their, you know, production side of things to make those one-off bikes.
And also people are building in steel, titanium, where you might not be able to get a bike motor off the shelf, a bike motor mount off the shelf.
Exactly. Yeah. So we're taking that pain out. The key thing for me as managing director of the company is to make it as easy for the brand to say yes. We want them to look at the system, ride the system, see how they can implement it into their bike very easily with the nature of our clamshell design. And basically, you know, start straight away. So we know it's very quick for them to design a frame around because it's what they know, bottom bracket.
But obviously those small manufacturers, that small volume stuff, that's not the limit of your aspirations for this motor. You think it's got like proper potential to be one of the big players in the market, I would have thought.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, the nature of the people that are involved in the company, our chairman is the former global CEO of Dyson for 15 years. And our consulting COO is a former director of operations of Dyson. We've got Rolls-Royce engineers, Jaguar Land Rover, you know, all coming across into the company. So we've got the best minds creating the lightest, or driving towards making the lightest, compact, efficient e-bike motor, which is what we've now got into production with.
So let's talk a little bit about the motor, Dave, because it's interesting from an internal point of view. I mean, one of the very interesting things about it is that you've designed it to be fully serviceable at any bike shop, effectively.
Yeah, I mean, the raw foundation of the transmission is a coaxial system. So the rider axle runs through every major component of the transmission. The nature of what we've created is that we've looked at what the industry is doing and said, well, we need to be a true green, clean tech, sustainable industry. And, you know, it needs to be serviceable. And we want to help the bike shops long term. And this is kind of being very sort of preemptive. Long term down the road, when a customer needs to have this serviced, they can literally go into any bike shop on the planet and get it serviced. We use standard bottom bracket bearings from Endura, so the bike shops have got those in stock. It's handing our technology over to people like SciTech that are now training mechanics, in advance of brands actually releasing lots of product out into the market, so that, you know, when there are challenges, and there always will be, you know, we create very technical products in the bicycle industry these days. The reality is the customer journey gets broken and eroded very quickly when they can't get their bike repaired. And so the nature is we want to be able to support that customer wherever that bike ends up being with our transmission in it. A few puddles coming up here. You've got the mud guards.
Proper British cycling this is. And let's talk a little bit more about the internals of the motor, because again, it's interesting. I mean, obviously I've just been on another trip to another part of Europe to have a look at another e-bike motor, which uses a kind of cyclical system to reduce the motor RPM. And you're using not the same system, but something that functionally is quite similar.
It's called a Flex Wave Harmonic Drive. So the flex part is the main gearbox, the harmonic cup, which we flex. It has what's called a wave generator bearing pushed into it, which is oval shaped. That then all sits into an outer ring, and we spin that wave generator bearing around 5,000 RPM, and we do in one reduction, the 66:1 reduction. So we don't have a planetary gearbox or a spur gearbox, which is how most of the market kind of works. So it means we can keep that tiny 121mm cylinder style bottom bracket transmission and create the gear reduction that we need by using a harmonic, which actually comes from the world of robotics. So we're the first company in the world to take that technology and really reapply it into a gearbox kind of format. It just gives us a system that you don't have the huge losses off of the electric stator because it's being reduced through a gearbox. So it means we can run a slightly smaller electric motor, which means we can be a little bit more efficient with our batteries. We can make a slightly lighter overall system and still achieve really market kind of ranges that people accept at this in these days.
And here we are chugging up a hill outside of Bishop Sutton in the beautiful Mendip Hills. Quite a steep one. Yeah. So you can really feel that motor kicking in along here. I've got it in the turbo mode, the highest mode.
So this tone you can hear right now is actually quieter on the new Vapor honed harmonics.
It's interesting because it's a very similar sound to the Mavic motor.
Yeah.
Which, you know, I guess you'd expect, because it's using a similar kind of reduction mechanism.
Yeah.
It's an EU Pedelec compliant motor, so continuously rated power of 250 watts.
Correct.
And at the moment, a 60 newton meter.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah, 60 newton meters in this configuration. We have a product roadmap to bring to market, you know, variations of that higher power torque side of things. But those are a few years down the road yet.
Okay, so what kind of markets are you looking at for those kind of motors then?
Well, right now we sit in gravel, hybrid, commuter, hardtail mountain bike. And then we want to be sort of going into the full fat mountain bike market. We do believe there's huge market opportunity around the cargo, last mile delivery side of things.
Sure.
So we believe we can be coming with a motor that can more than handle that sort of 300 kilo payload, whatever it needs to be. So I'm just going to talk you through the motor system that we've created at Freeflow Technologies. It's a mid-drive coaxial system. By coaxial, we mean the rider axle runs through the gearbox, the clutch arrangement, the one-way bearings, the torque sensor, the main rotor, through the electronics boards and out the other side. So we can keep the system very compact. But to dive more into the inner workings of our transmission, it's not the normal transmission that most people are seeing. So we created what's called a Flex Wave Harmonic Drive. This uses a Flex Wave Harmonic cup, and we flex that material to get the drive out of the system. So I'll just take that apart now. So the cranks would come off quite simply. So then any bike shop can access the bottom bracket bearings on this system. Getting further into the actual motor itself, the motor stator stays embedded within the motor case. It's bonded in. So that would stay in, and you would pull the gearbox directly out of that motor stator. This is the harmonic. It's a steel cup with a tooth profile on the outside. I can show you that. That's the tooth profile. The tooth profile then has a couple more teeth on it compared to the harmonic. And so when engaged, the motor is spinning at 5,000 RPM and turning the wave generator bearing on the inside here. This is an oval shaped bearing. And what that's now doing is it's changing the shape of the steel cup. That's why it's called a flex cup. And what that's doing is it's dropping the tooth profile down every revolution, one tooth profile, moving it along and putting it back up and engaging it for the drive. So as we can see, as we turn this more, the cup starts to walk itself around, and that's the drive of our system. And this means that we're not getting the losses that we see in a planetary or spur gearbox. So we can run a slightly smaller motor stator, we get better battery efficiencies, which means we get roughly the same ranges as our market competitors with smaller batteries. The nature of the small coaxial system means the bike looks like a normal bike, but the nature of the clutches and the harmonic drive, because when you go past that regulatory speed, the only resistance you have on the whole system is the bottom bracket bearings and the pedal bearings, which is exactly the same as an acoustic analog bike. So the bike has a normal ride feel once the system turns itself off.
So like we've already said, this is a motor that's in production. Company's up and running, you're selling motors, but also at the moment there's an opportunity for people to get involved, invest in the company.
Yeah, we've got a really interesting bunch of investors involved. We've got Williams Advanced Engineering, or Williams Formula One, invested in us as well. But in this current funding round, we want to give the end consumer that's going to be buying these bikes ultimately in the future the opportunity to be part of a really successful company. So we have a seeders funding round where, you know, people can come in with whatever level of investment they want to get involved in. They can see our pitch deck, our business plan, and see that, you know, we are a very big company down the road, not that far. And we've got great aspirations to scale this to a, you know, to be a real market player. We're looking at making it green, making it clean tech that is, you know, is really relevant in this space.
So that's the new Freeflow Technologies motor. Lots of interesting stuff happening in the e-bike sphere at the moment. This is certainly an interesting motor. If you want to learn more about it, then you can head over to the Freeflow Technologies website or their Seeders funding page, and there's links to both of those in the description below. And if you've enjoyed this video, don't forget to like it and subscribe for more like this from Road.cc. We'll see you soon.